My name is Kurt Anderson. I'm the Senior Director of International Recruitment and Partnerships at San Jose State. And I will be moderating and introducing this info session. I'll be joined by the Chair of the Department of Applied Data Science, Dr. Li Chang. Also by Paranaz Zartoshti, who's the Director of International Student Scholar Services. That's the unit that helps international students with their advising, visa issues, and much, much more. Let's talk a little bit about what we'll be talking about in this seminar. The agenda for the presentation is first a little bit of a description of the Way to San Jose program. Then Dr. Chang will be talking about the MS data analytics program. We'll have some frequently asked questions from international students in the COVID-19 situation, as well as some discussion of the global Spartan orientation. First, let's talk about the Way to San Jose program. This is a pathway for admitted graduate students into some of the more popular degree programs at San Jose State. The idea is that students will take online courses this fall, up to 9 units, and do that from the safety of their home, and also by doing that, and not have to deal with getting visas or traveling on airplanes or finding housing in San Jose. But one of the highlights of the program is that while students are getting their courses online, they are also uniquely getting opportunities that they might also get online on campus, such as advising services, online career fairs, career center events, and then, of course, in some cases, lectures from Silicon Valley experts who are nearby and influence the data analytics program in itself. The courses themselves will be delivered in a format that allows interaction with professors. So there'll be live interaction. There may also be recorded sessions that can be viewed at any time. We estimate that by taking online courses from your home, from your home country, that you would save about $10,000 in living expenses for the fall. And we see this as being an on-ramp for you to start your studies at San Jose State on our campus in the spring of 2021. With that, let's move on to an introduction of our main speaker tonight, which will be Dr. Li Chang, who is the department chair for the MS program in data analytics.
Thank you, Kurt. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the webinar. Let me introduce this program. The curriculum was developed with industry participants. There are about 20 companies joined us to develop the program in 2018. And the courses are taught by all professors and experts of Silicon companies. The key right now is those people bring the experience to our university. And meanwhile, they might introduce their own products or project to us, and they might hire our students for internship or permanent employees. All students could work on project portfolios for 2 years. From day one, they'll work on project already. And for you guys, maybe only 1.5 year can be done. This portfolio has combined domain knowledge, data science methodologies, and information technologies. It's very unique. As of the state, you are medical students, you are health science, you are in chemistry, whatever, bring in your domain knowledge and combine the methodology we'll teach you. You can build very, very impressive portfolio for your interviews. Our degree requires 10 courses. Each course is 3 units. So there are 30 units altogether. Okay, next slide, please, Cindy. Here's the proposed class schedule. As you can see, the first class can be waived if you pass the test. All of you are conditionally admitted right now, as you know. You'll take a test in August, or late July, you pass the test, you don't take data 200. You just take three courses, 220, 225, 228. In spring, you take three more. In summer, two more. And in fall 2021, you're going to graduate in December. If you want other variations, you can contact me. We can accommodate you if we can. Thank you. That's all for my presentation.
Okay. Hello, everyone. And congratulations on being admitted to the MSDA program. It's a very competitive program that Dr. Chang runs. So congratulations on that. I'm not certain if some of you are here in the United States or are actually abroad. So what I'm going to address a little bit is with regard to F1 immigration regulations. As most of you know, F1 immigration regulations limit the number of online courses that international students can take during an academic semester or term. However, due to COVID-19 in spring 2020, the Student Exchange Visitor Program made an exception, allowing all online classes for F1 students. So at this point, as you are aware, for fall 2020, SJSU has determined that the mode of instruction will be online and hybrid. So our office, International Student and Scholar Services, is waiting for further guidance from Student Exchange Visitor Program regarding online courses and being able to continue to maintain your status. So if you are outside of the country, I know there's several questions which come up regularly from many of our international students who are not in the United States at this point. So the question is, if I can't get a visa for fall 2020 due to the embassy shutdown, will I be able to take online classes and then arrive on campus in a later time when possible to continue with my studies? And the answer is yes, absolutely. That is what the way to San Jose is. You would enroll in online courses. If you have received your I-20, you can go ahead and pay your CVIS fee. If you haven't paid it, don't worry about it. You can wait until right before your visa interview. So the CVIS fee is unique to the CVIS ID that you have been issued. If for some reason you have paid the DS-160 application fee as well, that fee is valid for 1 year. So you have 1 year to apply for your F1 visa. Another question that comes up is for students who are in their home countries and taking online classes in fall 2020, they're wondering when they would be eligible for CPT. So from an immigration perspective, you need to actually be in the country to be considered an F1 status. So hopefully by January 2021, you would be able to enter the United States and enroll in in-person classes at San Jose State. So you would be full-time in spring. Full-time is considered 9 units during spring and fall. If you're eager to start your CPT sooner, then you would enroll full-time in summer. Full-time is considered 6 units. And by fall 2021, you would be eligible for CPT. We do have a list of frequently asked questions on our website, which I encourage all of you to review frequently. We will be updating that as we learn more and as we receive further guidance from the Student Exchange Visitor Program. It's right here on our website. You can find it under the Resources tab. So please visit this page frequently. We also have a slew of other great information on our website, especially under the New Students tab. So I encourage all of you to visit the website. So I just want to emphasize that ISSS, International Student and Scholar Services, is here to support you not only with your immigration needs, but also with your programming needs to help you adjust to the SJSU community and to feel like you are part of our community. So even if you are outside of the United States, we do have a lot of programs to support you. So we have what is called Global Spartan Welcome. So it is required for all new international students. It is in addition to the graduate student orientation, which is managed by the College of Graduate Studies. It is also in addition to your departmental orientation, with which Dr. Chang will be running. Global Spartan Welcome is really just designed for international students. There's no fee to attend. And it's an opportunity to connect with all of us, the staff and other international students, global leaders, and to help you navigate the cultural transitions and to learn more about maintaining your F1 status. We could have the next slide. So we do have a special session, two special sessions being offered in August. For those of you who will be abroad, if you are actually in the country, all the sessions will be virtual, so you would be able to participate at an earlier date in August, but you are required to register. We are a little later in communicating with our incoming students this year due to COVID-19 and the uncertainty of the situation. So you will be receiving an email from our office sometime in July alerting you of these different options. And finally, we do offer a lot of programming beyond Global Spartan Welcome. So we do have optional online events in August and September. And there will be different workshops to help you transition to SJSU and life in the United States, regardless of whether or not you are here in the United States or outside of the country. So, for example, there will be a workshop on strategies for online learning. So lots of great things to look at. We look forward to welcoming you to SJSU, whether it's virtually in the fall and then in person in the spring. But our unit, International Students and Scholar Services, is here to support you throughout your tenure here at SJSU.